Okay, so here we'll be looking at the concept of the relative speed. So the speed of one body in relation to another moving body is called the relative speed of the first body with respect to the other one. So suppose there is this ball and it is moving at a speed of 2 meter per second in this direction, and there is another ball which is moving at a speed of 1 meter per second in the same direction. So now we have to find out, if this is ball number 1 and if this is ball number 2, then we have been given the speed of first ball is 2 meter per second and the speed of second ball is 1 meter per second. Now if we have to find out the speed of first ball with respect to the other, so V12, what we do is we simply subtract the speed of the second ball from the speed of the first ball. So V12 will be equal to V1 minus V2, which is 1 meter per second. Note that this is true because they are moving in the same direction. So we could also visualize it in a manner. So what we can do is we can keep the ball 2 at rest. So let ball 2 be at rest. So this is at rest. If we have kept this ball at rest, we have to keep all other objects behind by 1 meter per second. So all other objects, so we have put 1 meter per second vector, that is 1 meter per second speed in this direction. So we should put 1 meter per second for this also, for all objects. So the speed of 1 would be 2 minus 1, which is 1 meter per second. This is how we compute the relative speed when the two objects are moving in the same direction. But now what happens if the objects are moving in the opposite directions? So let there be object 1 and let this be object 2. Now let 1 be moving with again 2 meter per second and let 2 be moving at 1 meter per second. So in this case, we should consider the signs as well. So in for this particular case, we will have V1 equal to 2 meter per second, but V2 will be minus 1 meter per second because it is moving in the opposite direction. So what will be the relative speed of 1 with respect to 2 in this case? It will become V1 minus V2, which is 2 plus 1, because minus of minus 1 is 3. Minus of minus 1 is plus 1. So 2 plus 1 equal to 3 meter per second. So we should remember this. If the objects are moving in the same direction, then the relative speed is found by making the difference of the two speed. And if they are moving in the opposite direction, then the relative speed is actually the sum of the two speeds. Now we'll be looking at a question from the same concept. So here we have been given a train crosses two persons cycling in the same direction as the train in 12 and 18 seconds respectively. Now if the speeds of the two cyclists are 9 and 18 km per hour, then find the length and speed of the train. So here, first thing, we are given the time in seconds. So we should change the speed of the cyclists instead of kilometer per hour into meter per second. So the speed of first cyclist given is 9 km per hour, which will be 9000 meter upon 3600 seconds. So 1 hour has got 3600 seconds. So this will come out to be 90 upon 36 is 2.5 meter per second. Now speed of the second cyclist is double, which is 18 km per hour. So double of 2.5 meter per second is 5 meter per second. Now we have been given the train. So the train is traveling at some particular speed Vt, let it be Vt. And the two cyclists are traveling. So C1 and C2 are traveling at a speed of 2.5 meter per second and 5 meter per second. Now clearly, if a train crosses a person, the train is traveling a distance of L with respect to the cyclist. So we have to keep in mind. So what we are trying to do here is, if this is a train and if this is a cyclist, here we know that this is the point, starting point, when the train meet the cyclist. And suppose this is the point where, so suppose let this be the point where the cyclist and the train are ending their meet. Okay, so in this time period, the cyclist has also traveled this distance, But the train has traveled this distance plus this distance. Because we are talking about the front part of the train. It was here, now it has reached here. So this particular point, if we are saying A, then this is A. The part of this particular point we are talking about. Okay, so the cyclist has also covered some distance and the train has also covered some distance and the train has covered this distance plus L, which is the length of the train. Okay, so this is the total, this distance traveled by the train is L with respect to the cyclist. The total distance would be something L, but with respect to cyclist, this is the distance. Now, if with respect to cyclist, this is the distance, then the speed we should also consider with respect to cyclist only. Now, we are given that the train passes the two cyclists in 12 and 18 seconds. Now, time is given by distance upon speed. So, distance upon speed. So, for the first case, where the distance is L with respect to the cyclist, the speed will be Vt minus 2.5. Why we took Vt minus 2.5 instead of just Vt? Because this is the speed of train with respect to the cyclist. And we have taken the distance also with respect to the cyclist. So we have to take this particular speed. And this time is given to be 12 seconds. Similarly, for the second cyclist, again, we have to take the relative speed, which is Vt minus 5. This is given to be 18 seconds. Now if we divide 18 upon 12 and this upon this, we will get Vt minus 2.5 upon Vt minus 5 is equal to 18 upon 12, which is 1.5. Okay. Now, if we cross multiply, we will have Vt minus 2.5 is equal to 1.5 Vt minus 5 into 1.5 is 7.5. Now, we bring this Vt here and this 7.5 here. So we will have 7.5 minus 2.5 equal to 1.5 Vt minus Vt, which gives us 0.5 Vt is equal to 5. So Vt is nothing but 10 meter per second. Now if the speed of the train is 10 meter per second, now we simply can put this in any of the two equations and get the length of the train. So we have to find the speed of the train as well as the length of the train. So now we'll use this particular equation. So we have L upon Vt minus 5 equal to 18 seconds. So L is nothing but 18 into Vt minus 5, which is 5. So the length of the train is 90 meter and the speed of the train is 10 meter per second. These are the two required quantities.